Namaste. Welcome to the RSK group of YouTube channels. Today we are here again with the chapter number 2 of class 7 history, and the name of the chapter is New Kings and Kingdoms. So with the topic we can easily understand that in this chapter we will read about the new kings and their new kingdoms also, which basically emerged during the period of 700 to 1750, because this period was also known as the medieval period, and so that occurred in the mid than that period. So, first of all, emergence of the new dynasties. As we have discussed earlier, that in the earlier times when the kings were there, they the king of Kannauj will obviously have a more power as compared to the other kings. So everybody wants to the power, king of Kannauj. That creates a conflict. So that leads to a conflict between all the three dynasties, which led to their decline also. So later on, first each and every dynasty, one by one, gradually they have the power over Kannauj and they started ruling the Kannauj, but for a very little time. Now coming to the administration and the kingdoms, and these types of some new entitlement they were happened at that time, like the Maharaja Dhiraj and the Chakravarti Samrat. All these types of these entitlements they emerged into in this period also, because once they became the king, they used to entitled them as the huge king or the Maharaja Dhiraj as the now prashasti and the land grants. To run a country or to run a kingdom very smoothly, it is first thing for the king to take the revenue from the people. So they made the system to take the revenue from the people, and because at the time the Brahmins were having a very powerful position in the society, so what did they do? The king used to grant the lands to the Brahmins and the Prashastis also, and all these things. So the Brahmins became very powerful. Even the travelers and the traders and even the rich persons used to give the different types of either the wealth or the money to the Brahmins, because they were doing the processions for them. So it was the Brahmin society which became very powerful, and they started, because the king used to give the lands or grant the lands to them. So they, and the rich person, they used to donate the money. So they built the temples also, and these temples, when the temple was being built, and new small types of shops they started emerging in front of the temple, and the people started living in that area, and the things became spread out, and which led to the temple town also. So the temple town, some of the temple towns at that time were very wealthy, because as I told you earlier, that the kings, they used to grant the wealth, the money, and even the land also to the Brahmins. So Brahmins were very powerful and they used to live in the temple. So many temple towns, they were very powerful and very wealthy, and that's why they attracted the invaders from outside to invade into the India. And the, basically the invaders, right from the Mahmud Ghazni or Muhammad Ghori, they used to invade India for more than 16 times, and they came India just for the wealth from the temple towns only, because they want to develop their country very much. For that they also need money, and for that money they used to invade India many times, and they looted the India, and especially the basically temple towns, and they used to take the money out from them, and again they came to invade India. So temple towns were very important at that time. Basically temple towns were being built on the lands that were being granted by the kings to the Brahmins. So Brahmins were having a very powerful position at that time, and even the wealthy people also used to donate the money to the Brahmins at that time also. So basically that era was basically ruled by the Brahmins, and which having the power, and they were having the